Thanks everyone for joining us for this week's weekly investment meeting. And the main topic I want to discuss today is the importance of inflation in valuations. And there's really two ways that I'm going to present today of how to look at it. But when we look at it from either way, they both have a fair value price target for the S&P significantly lower than where we are today. So let me show you what I mean. When you look at inflation historically, it tends to compress valuations. So there's an inverse relationship between the PE ratio of the S&P as well as the inflation rate. And I know there's a lot of numbers and math on here, so let me walk you through that. What we have is a scatter plot going back to 1965 of looking at the inflation rate and what the PE ratio was at the time. And you can see the PE ratio is on the y-axis and inflation is at the bottom on the x-axis. And then you can see the trend line shown in black. So when we look at today's 8.5% annual inflation rate, given this relationship, it would give you an implied PE ratio of 10.93. So I have from the bottom, the solid red arrow, that's the current inflation rate. And you can see as it goes left, the left arrow shows you where this PE ratio would be. Now the converse would be looking at the current PE ratio of a little over 20, going from the x-axis from left to right and hitting the trend line going down, that implies an inflation rate of 1.1%. So clearly one of these things is off, whether it's inflation is too high or the PE ratio is too high. But when you look at it, and we can basically use the formula for this trend line, and we basically get a price target of 22.38. So the implied PE ratio of 10.93 times the trailing earnings per share of $204.79 gives us a price target of 22.38 for the S&P. Now you can see where how far off the current market is from that. Basically, if we applied that PE ratio, it would indicate that the market needs to fall 46% or basically retest the March 2020 lows. Now, as the inflation rate comes down, obviously that price target moves up. So if the inflation rate moves down to, let's say, 6% or so, that would start to move the price target up. But an 8.5% inflation rate, this kind of gives you an idea of how overvalued the market is, given how aggressive inflation is running right now. Now, there's another indicator which is used for kind of a real simplistic way, rule of thumb, of coming up with the fair value for the S&P. And that is taking the current inflation rate plus the trailing PE ratio should equal approximately 20. So if you have the current inflation rate, you take 20 minus that, and that gives you where the trailing PE ratio should be. And the reason why I want to bring this up is that there's essentially an indicator or some data going around, which I was looking at this back in April, but it turns out I wasn't the original creator. Larry Williams was. But essentially what I studied was looking at if a new bull market exceeds that 50% retracement level, does it ever hit a new low? Or basically trying to differentiate a new bull market from a bear market bounce. And what I found going from 1950 on was that we never saw the S&P exceed the 50% retracement mark and hit a new low on a closing value basis. We did see it in the 1940s in the post-World War II recovery. We also saw it during the Great Depression. So it's not flawless. But the reason why I want to bring the rule of 20 up is this was basically some data brought up by the head of quantitative strategy at B of A, basically saying that this rule of 20 has had a flawless track record of picking market bottoms. And so it kind of goes counteractive to what we saw with the 50% retracement study that a lot of people are looking at to make the call that the S&P is in a new bull market. So you can see basically when we look at from the early 1950s all the way to the mid 1980s, when you look at the PE ratio plus the inflation rate, that is shown in red, and the horizontal line is 20. And basically every bottom that we have seen has saw the PE plus inflation rate lower than 20. So you can see that again in the 50s, the 60s, 70s, and even in the early 80s, there was not one single major bottom that occurred north of the rule of 20. Basically, every major bottom saw the PE plus inflation less than 20. You can see that also in the early 80s to the 2000s. The 87 crash finally bottomed when that indicator was below 20. We saw the 1990-91 recession and bear market that also drove that ratio below 20. And then we saw the correction in the tech bubble. It finally bottomed. Look how long the tech bubble lasted. That bear market was roughly almost 3 years. And every bear market bounce was very significant. A lot of people thought the bottom was in, but the rule of 20 did not apply. Basically, the PE plus inflation rate was still too high. Now, we know back then inflation wasn't running what it was today. It was more of a valuation adjustment where valuations needed to come down. But when you look at the bottom in 2002, the bottom finally came when that ratio went below 20, meaning that valuations finally came down enough to put in a solid bottom. When we look at the last quarter century, you could see that the great financial crisis, the bottom occurred well below 20. The bottom that we saw in 2010, 2011, those also were still below the rule of 20. The 2015-16 corrective period, that also, those bottoms were below the rule of 20. And then we get to the Powell tightening bear market of 2018. The market bottomed in December 26th of 2018, well below that rule of 20 threshold. And even the COVID bear market went well below that 20 threshold. When you look at today, we're at 29, which basically means the PE needs to come down, inflation needs to come down, or actually both. That essentially at a current 8.5% inflation rate, the PE is way too high, or the inflation rate is way too high. So this does kind of give you an idea of it could be and would be likely premature to say the coast is clear and the bottom is in. Now, one thing we can do, again, the rule of 20 is used to come up with a fair value for the S&P. Essentially, what I did is I took the inflation rate to get the implied PE times the trailing earnings per share to basically give me the price target for the S&P. And so you can see that whenever you've had a pretty big derivation, it either marked a significant top or bottom in the S&P. And currently, we are well above the estimated price target for the S&P of 2349. Here, what I'm looking at is the deviation from that price target implied by the rule of 20. So you can see that a lot of the peaks that we saw, major significant peaks, saw a pretty high deviation of the S&P from the implied price target. And when you look at where we are today, this is basically saying that the S&P is 80% above where it should be based on the price target. And this is even north of the tech bubble in 2000. So when you look at this analysis and you see that every major bear market bottom found that it was with a rule of 20 below that, it does kind of call to question if the bottom's truly in. Now here, what I'm showing is the rule of 20 on the top, and on the bottom is the drawdown from the S&P from a 52-week high. So you can see that red horizontal line on that bottom panel, that basically is the bear market threshold. So a bear market would be greater than a 20% or greater decline. And you can look vertically to see that every time we dip low into bear market territory, the rule of 20 applied, meaning that the PE plus inflation rate was well below that. Here is a zoomed in region of that over the last 15 years or so. And we can see, again, when we had that huge bear market of the great financial crisis, the rule of 20 applied. And when we look at, again, the mini bear market of 2018, the COVID bear market, we saw the rule of 20 also implied. So clearly, when you look at where we are right now, combined PE and inflation rate of 29, it really does mean, in my opinion, that it's probably too premature to say that the bottom is in. So here is kind of looking at the same thing. It's the rule of 20 plus the S&P going back 25 years. And the current PE ratio of the S&P is 20.32. The current inflation rate is 8.5. So to have confidence that a bottom is in, what we want to see is that rule of 20 applied. So to get to 20, we either need to see the PE ratio fall to 11.5, or we need to see a negative annual inflation rate of negative 0.32. Now, I think both of those are nowhere close to being a reality, which is why I still think we need more time and probably lower prices. So clearly, again, to me, I think this does suggest caution. I know there's a lot of bullish commentary that the bottom is in, given that 50% retracement. That rule has failed. I've tested it and looked at it. It failed in the 40s. It failed in the Great Depression. It's not infallible. But what so far has not failed is that rule of 20. And when you look at what that is implying, it does imply that the S&P is well above where it should be trading based on that metric. We'll keep an eye on this and we'll update readers as we move along to see how that converges. And we hope you have a wonderful week.
That concludes this week's Financial Sense Investment Summary. If you have any questions about any of the topics discussed or about any of our personalized investment services, feel free to give us a call at 888-486-3939 or email us at grow@financialsense.com. Also, listen to our podcast, Financial Sense News Hour. It's on iTunes, Spotify, or on our website at financialsense.com.